Welcome to Analytics with Nags. In this video, we're going to see about interaction between charts. Let's see what is an interaction. When I want to click on this chart, and my next chart should reflect the data for that. So these kind of features, by default, most of the dashboards are not providing. But how to implement this in Power BI? And this is one of the coolest feature that Power BI provides. And in modern dashboarding tools like Tableau also provides this, but let us see how we need to implement in Power BI. Let's have it, let's see our dashboard here. This is our previous dashboard that we have created. Same dashboard I have created in Excel using this data. And now you can see it like the same dashboard, same, it's like a pie chart over here. And now assume like the scenario, we have an online order. Based on the online order clicked, this chart should reflect the online, only the online orders. These behaviors, it's very difficult to implement in Excel. Most of them not aware. Even we can able to implement in Excel, but I just want to explain what is the interaction over here. So clicking on one chart, it should reflect other charts. Let's see how we can develop in Power BI. So let me minimize these things quickly. So as we discussed, so when user clicks on online order, it should filter these charts. What are the data for other charts? So when I click on it, it still filters it, and the total quantity sold is 73. And in jeans Levi's, item name jeans Levi's, item amount 2,54,000, highlighted is 25,300. So this 25,300 belongs to this online order. So that is what it means. When I uncheck it, it will go away. So this is the behavior that's I'm trying to explain. So how, when the user clicks on it, it should reflect, it should filter it. But some people doesn't like it to see in this manner. So instead, what they want to see is like, because one of the issue over here is the jeans lega, there is no data at all. If you see the jeans lega, there is no data at all for the online, but it's still showing here. So that creates confusion for most of the people. So people don't want to see this one. Instead, what they want is when they click on the online order, the entire report should be filtered. So this behavior, what to do? That is what our interaction is. By default, we have a highlighted view. We go to format and edit interactions. So then what has to be done for this chart? If something clicked on this chart, what other visuals should behave? That is what we are going to explain. By default, it is a highlight. So now you can see it's in highlight mode. Let's do it by clicking on filter. You can see, guys, the data is filtered. Basically, when you this can be applied to other visuals as well. So either it can be highlight or filter. It depends upon our choice. So now we are dead for this particular chart, and it can be applicable to other charts as well. So when a user clicks on this particular chart, I mean, let's see it once again. So now it's working fine. That's what, see, when the user clicks on item amount name, then these two are not filtered. Okay, so the interaction is done for only one chart. When the item amount order is clicked, then these two, this item amount item name is filtered. But when item amount item name is clicked, these two are still in a highlighted mode. So this property has to be set for each of the charts. Now still it shows highlighted. Okay, this is the thing I want to explain. So for this chart also I want to set it as a filter. Let us click on this chart and filter these two charts. For this chart I want to make it as highlighted for other two charts. Click on it. So these two charts are filtering. Now clicking on this, I want to keep that one as highlighted, so just keep it highlighted. I hope you guys understand this behavior now. If you guys like this video, please share this video and subscribe this channel, and do remember that data is your asset.